Hey guys, it's Echo. Here we are again, or I am, with a new video. And as you probably can already tell, this is gonna be a bit different because Journey isn't here today. He's on vacation, so here's me. So today, we're playing a different game in the Strange Man series. The Crooked Man, which I believe is the first in the series, but I'm not sure. But anyways, let's get into it. Of course, there's a horror warning, so don't watch if you can't handle, horror and stuff. There was a crooked man, and he walked a crooked mile. He found a crooked sixpence, upon a crooked stile. He bought a crooked cat, which caught a crooked mouse. This creepy music is. And they all lived together in a crooked little house. Okay, that's not creepy at all. Phew, finally, Paul. Phew, finally things look tidy in here. That should be that. Is there anything else we can help with, David? Nah, I'm fine. Sorry for making you guys help me move. And thanks for showing me the place, Paul. I'll have to pay you back sometime. Okay, so I guess Paul and the girl are a couple or something. Oh, nice. The three of us could go out drinking. Oh, Marianne, that's her name. I look forward to it already. Well, it's late. We'd better get going. Got it. Be careful, you two. I'm gonna do voices because it's gonna kill my voice if I do. Oh, okay, we can play now. Okay, let's look around. An old TV. Cupboards. A refrigerator. What's that? Oh, huh? Jeez, Paul forgot his license. I should get it to him if he's still around. Okay, so we got Paul's license. Is there anything else we need to look at? Probably not. That's a very small. Oh, there's more rooms. Is that something up there? No. Oh well. Wait. Let's go give him the. Oh. What's with that place? Seriously, it's filthy. It's probably practically falling apart. What were you thinking? Oh, is that Marian talking? He wanted to move for a change of pace, and it will not help me. Him. You hear? Look, what can I do? He's not the richest guy, and not many places come with furniture. It's the couple talking, right? Besides, you told me to look for the place, right? Don't come complaining to me now. You're right. I'm sorry. I just want to help David out. I know. Look, I should be sorry. We'll pay him a visit sometime. Oh, okay, so they're arguing about his apartment? The license can wait, I guess. Better get to bed. Okay, so let's look around the house for a bit. Is this many clothes inside? Doesn't seem to be many things around, but we can look either way. A washing machine. That's a big ass washing machine. Oh, the curtain can open. A bathtub. Is that water in the bathtub? Why? Well, probably not, but why would there be? Oh, the phone's ringing. Hello? Hello? Who is this? Shirley? Oh, wait, so it was no one. I'll just call it a day. I should take it easy for my first day in the new place. Okay, there's creepy calls and he hasn't even been there for that long. There's a large crack on the wall. That's probably gonna come in later. Anyway, let's get to bed, I guess. Man, I am tired in all sorts of ways. Oh. Ugh, really? Is that somebody crying? I can't sleep through this crying. Is it one of the neighbors? I should go ask. Okay. Ooh, it's dark now. Tool five. Oh, I didn't see what that said. Oh, knocking gets no response. That's 204. Knocking gets no response. Woman's voice. Yes? Who is it at this hour? Pardon me, I can hear you from my room even. It's making it hard to sleep. Would you stop? Huh? What are you saying? I was asleep until you woke me up. You trying to start something? Oh, so it was neither of them. You're the guy who moved in 204, right? There's no way you'd hear me from up, oh, from there. Or I guess so. Sorry for waking you. Bye now. Oh, nice. Creepy phone calls and creepy crying sounds at night. She's right. The rooms are pretty far apart. More importantly, it was a man's voice. Was it just my imagination? A man's voice? Whatever. I better get back to sleep. Can I go downstairs? Oh, no. Oh, dear. What's that sound? Oh, yikes. The water. Is the faucet busted? Wow, that was a funny sound effect. Under the bed. Under the bed. Is Paul trying to prank me? Talk about it, bad taste. Okay, so there's so much happening already. Under the bed. Should can't click on the bed or something. Oh, under the bed, huh? What's down there? Here. Found something. Found a scrap from a notebook. Ever since she went away, I've spent every night clutching my sweaty pillow and writhing. I can't say goodbye. What other choice do I have? All right then. What's this? Did the former tenant leave this? Why would the Oh, whatever. I'll get to bed. How is he so calm with all these creepy things happening? I would be out of there. That sound still? Where is it coming from? Give me a break. I need sleep. Oh, it's the hall again. I hope it's another creepy phone call. Hello? Yeah, thanks for all the. No, I didn't mean. Just, I'm busy with work, so. Yes, I'll come visit today. Tell her that for me. Okay, bye. Oh, who was that? Man, I slept into noon. I'd better go. So much for taking it easy. I don't probably take anything with me, right? Probably not. Oh. Paul, what is it? Yeah, I forgot my license yesterday. Was it on the table? Oh, yeah, this. Sorry, I was going to bring it to you, but. Whew, thanks! So. What was that sound I just made? So, you going somewhere? Yeah, to the hospital. The hospital? I see. Take care of yourself, buddy. Oh yeah, Paul. Did you write something on the bathroom mirror? Write on the mirror. What kind of prankster kid do you have me for? Do you take me for, David? Sorry, I didn't mean like that. Anyway, I'm off. Okay, so we're gonna visit someone in the hospital. Voices. Mom, oh. Mom, it's been a while. Are you doing okay? What are those noises? Oh my, if it isn't little Timmy, you've certainly grown. Good, you look healthy. Sorry, I can't see you very much. I've been busy with work. But I took a few days off and I moved to this great room with furniture and everything. It's near your favorite cake shop too. So when you get better, we can live there together. My, that's wonderful. Get along with Linda, will you? Who is Linda and Timmy? All that fighting you do worries me so. Maybe I can visit you sometime? You like apple pie, don't you? I'll make the best I know how. Mom, I'm not Timmy. Oh, I didn't see what that said. I think it said I'm your son, David. Oh, yes, they opened a bakery the other day. It smells so wonderful. Maybe I should buy from there. She does not look healthy. Mom? Oh, who would you be? Why are you here? Oh, does she have Alzheimer's or something? How did you get in? This is my room. Do you have the wrong room? Who are you? Say something, will you? Ma, get out! I'll have you thrown out! Somebody, somebody! There's a strange man in my room! Get rid of him now! Okay, so she does not remember us at all. Miss Hoover. Mrs. Hoover, don't strain yourself. Please go to sleep, okay? Who are you? Don't touch me. Away! Nurse. Oh, nurse one was talking before, so now this is nurse two. Now, calm down, miss. Let's get you into bed. Sorry, David. Leave your mother to us. You'll have to leave for the day. Understood. Take good care of her. Davy? Is that my Davy boy? Where are you going? Why are you leaving me? Oh, so now she remembers you. Mom? Your flight school exams are coming up. You want to be a pilot, don't you? Your mother always has your back. Please don't leave me alone. I don't want to be alone here. Davy, please. Oh man, this is getting very emotional from the get-go. Mom, it's me, remember? Mom? David, please leave for the day. She's very confused right now. But she said my. I said leave! Oh, that does not sound good. Miss Hoover, please calm down. Bring the sedatives. That is not nice. Oh, that's not good. I'm guessing we can't go back in, but. Oh, there was a doctor there. Hello, David. Did you see your mother? Yeah. Though I guess she still doesn't know me. Yes, she's forgotten many things, and she's having trouble controlling her emotions. Yeah, that's evident. I ask you to be patient. She may well get better, so can you live with her? Oh, so you can live with her again. Thanks. I hope you can help her. Oh, it was the chair. The chair wasn't there before, was it? Oh, did I move the chair? There's something in the drawer. Got a leaflet for a school. A school. Looks pretty old. These LLM courses are circled. I don't know what that means. Was somebody shooting to be a lawyer? I guess this must be the former tenants. He sure forgot a bunch of stuff. Maybe no furniture is better after all, huh? Okay, so he keeps finding old stuff again. Oh, there we go with the phone calls again. Hello? Marion. Oh, it's Marion. Hey, David. How are you doing? Haha, you saw me just yesterday. I'm doing fine, thanks. Good, good. Call if you're ever lonely, okay? By the way, I got a call from Shirley yesterday. We didn't really talk, but. Sorry, I told her your number. She said she was so worried about you. It's okay. Tell her I don't need her worry. She should just look out for herself. Alright, well, I'll hang up now. Alright, see you. I'm tired of reading. I should go to bed. Hope nothing. Oof. I was just about to say, hope nothing creepy happens, but here we are. Why did it turn on by itself? Is it broken? Sink? What? Did that say sink? What the hell? This is creepy. Now you think this is creepy. Did it say sink? What was that? Guess we'll go check out the sink. Maybe. Or, like, is it the kitchen sink? Oh, probably. There's a scrap of paper under here. Why is there paper everywhere? And how did that not get wet? Go a scrap of paper. There was a crooked man and he walked a crooked mile. Oh, he found the crooked sixpence upon a crooked stile. He bought a crooked cat, which is called a crooked mouse, and they all lived together in a crooked little house. Okay, so there's that creepy poem again. Is this a Mother Goose rhyme? Why is it here under the sink? I guess the previous tenant? Yeah, if that's from the previous tenant, he was a pretty weird guy. Somewhat strange stuff. I should just sleep and forget about it. How can he sleep in that apartment? Or apparently the previous night he couldn't at least. Moving for a change of pace, huh? Guess that's not working so well. I appreciate Paul and Marion's help, but. Kid I hear this late at night? And what kid would live in these beat up apartments? Heck, maybe they're lost. I should go check. Okay. Oh. Can I move? Oh. Of course there are no kids here. Must be getting tired. Oh. Something broke. Can I? Knock around, but what am I supposed to do? I suppose there's a stick. Okay, so no. Where did I go? Wasn't there a sound of something breaking? Was it inside? Doesn't seem to be anything broken. Just a broken cup. Jeez, that startled me. How did it? Wait, what? Help me. The cup is spilling out? You gotta be. This room is really, really strange. With its voices and TVs turning on. What is this? A horror game. Did he not clean the coffee? Hi, Paul. It's David. Yeah, what's up? Man, you sound sleepy. Haha. Haha, yeah. Was up all last night. I gotta ask you something. Is now okay? Yeah, what? Do you know who used to live in this room? Nah, I don't know. You ask the landlady? You curious about something? Well, seems like he forgot a lot of stuff. But I'll ask the landlady, sure. Later. The landlady is on the far end of the first floor. I'll go see what she knows. So I guess we're on the second floor, right? Oh, the phone. There is so many cracks in this building. Can you interact with something else? Hello? Oh, it's Mr. David. What seems to be the matter? Good day, miss. I just wanted to ask something. You see, about the room I'm in. Can you tell me anything about the person who used to live there? Well, you know, these apartments always have people coming and going. Now, what was that boy's name? I believe he was a man about your age. He suddenly left about a month ago. Said to leave the furniture and use it, however. You wouldn't know where he went? I never heard that, no. Really just up and left out of the blue. I just can't remember that name. I could rummage through my documents to find the previous tenants if you'd like. No, there is no need. I was just a little curious. Thanks, I'll see you around. Alrighty, sorry I wasn't very useful. Probably the previous tenant left because of all the creepy stuff happening. A man about my age. I can only wonder what he was like. Oh well, I'll get back to my room. Alright. Ooh, are those footsteps? Why are there these tracks on the floor? They lead up to this wall. Is there something in this crack? Got a brass key. A brass key? This key is pretty fancy. I doubt for anything in here, so I wonder where. We haven't seen anything that we can unlock, right? The guy's voice, the kids' voices, the mirror writing, the TV turning on, the coffee. Huh, it's kind of like a poltergeist or something. But I would have thought the landlady would mention this kind of thing. Why would she mention that? So no one gets the room? Like, anyway, what's going on here? Not that I'd much care if there were any ghosts here. Nobody'd be too bothered if they hunted and killed me either. Oh, that's very depressing. But I wonder about that scrap of paper. What was the man who lived here like? Did this stuff happen when he was here? Not much use thinking about it. I'll call it a day. Yeah, he needs to clean up at some point. Why? Where's that coming from? Is it from inside the house? Oh, I do not like this. I can imagine it's the computer, maybe? Oh, no? Maybe the TV again? No? Is it the phone? Where is it coming from? Where else could it come from? Oh, it came from in here. Oh, I don't like that. Radio? What's. Why is this in my closet? Not to mention it turning on by itself. There's something on this paper here. It's an address? Our special place. Where's that supposed to be? Okay, so we got a people and others. Can we close that? No? Okay, well, a black terrifying boy it is. What? I'm waiting for you. In blood, of course. I'm waiting for you? What? Why did... How? And when did it... What? That's a reasonable response to that. So, you sleep well last night? Sorry you had to sleep on the couch. Nah, I should be sorry for coming over so late. Ha, wasn't expecting it, but don't sweat it. But hey, did something happen? You don't look too hot. Oh, there's no particular reason, of course. Or maybe I felt like intruding into the newlywed's love nest. Hey, why you... Ha, just kidding. Seriously though, you can tell me if anything happens, okay? I'll do whatever I can for you. Alright, heh, I'm glad to know a guy who looks out for his friends. Hey, you making fun of me? Oh yeah, I heard from Marion. Sorry about the Shirley thing. I told her off for that. Don't worry about it, it's not Marion's fault. Well, it's not about whose fault it is. I'm just not happy about it. Don't let it get you down, alright? I know you've got your mother to look after, but I think it's time you move on and look for new people. As if a guy like me could find a date. I'm just some clerk with a mom in the hospital. And the girl I wanted to marry ran from me. Oof, that doesn't sound too great. I guess that's why he's all sad. Man, don't be such a sissy. You keep up that moping and you'll have your own personal rain cloud. Huh, well, I'll be careful. Oh, so I'm going to go on a little trip. Don't want to waste my vacation, you know. Oh, great idea. Where are you going? Just somewhere I was wondering about. I'll call you when I get there. Oh, please don't tell me he's going to that house. Sweet, send a postcard. Breakfast's ready, Paul. David, will you be eating too? Nah, I'm not hungry. I'll be going. Aw, that's too bad. Come by anytime you like. There. Looks like this address is in the mountains. About a 5-hour drive. Did the former tenant go here? I just want to ask him about this room. Maybe he'll know something. Hell, I'll go right now. I can't stand this place anyway. I don't understand why he thinks all these papers are the former tenants doing. Like, if there's weird supernatural blood writing on the wall, why would the papers not be? Prologue. David's room. Oh, alright, so we finished the prologue. I guess this would be a good place to also finish the episode. So, thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. And me and Journey will be back soon with a new video. Bye!